And now I'm going to show you my all-around favorite audio editing tool. I learned about this tool from Robin McConkey. I'm in the Robin fan club. She is one of our professional members at Evalogue.Life, and she's in Australia. She is a professional broadcaster for ABC, the Australian Broadcasting Corporation, and now she does storytelling and has a podcast and interviews people about their lives, especially in the bush and rural Australia. So she does marvelous work. And when she told me that TwistedWave is her tool of choice, I just bought it sight unseen. So I am going to show you now how I use it. First, we're going to record an audio. You can either import audio or you can record audio. In this case, we're going to record one. You can change your settings here. This is important if you want it to be in both ears. You need to make sure it's set at stereo. If you only do one ear, it's going to be mono. There are times when something will detect wrong and it will record as mono when really you want it to be stereo, in which case you're going to need to run it through an audio editor and change that setting. That's beyond the scope of this tutorial, but just a heads up if you ever only hear sound coming out of one side. So, okay, go ahead and hit okay. And now we're going to record. Okay, now we are recording, and I'm also going to pause here to show you how to delete in the middle. All right, now we're talking again, and I'm going to do a shorter pause to show you something else. All right, now we're recording again, and that is it. Now let's listen to what we've done here. So I will bring the yellow bar here over to where it begins. Okay, now we are recording. Okay, that's pretty quiet. You may not even be able to hear that through the computer. So there's an easy way to change the volume. You can just click on this handy little button right here and normalize to peak value is what I'm going to choose. Hit apply, and all of a sudden, look at how the volume looks higher there, and I'm going to hit play and you can hear it. Okay, now we are recording, and I'm also awesome. Going, that sounds great. Now you'll notice these waves here are the sound portion of your audio. These are the silent spaces. You can manually delete the silent spaces by sliding this yellow bar and hitting delete. That's all you have to do. Slide and hit delete. We're going to leave that pause there because I want to show you something in a minute. And delete. Nice. Now let's start from the beginning and you can hear it all the way through. Okay, now we are recording, and I'm also going to pause here to show you how to delete in the middle. Okay, so I've shown you how to manually trim, but I'm going to show you something even cooler. Let's undo that, what I just did there, and you can go into, let's see, actually, select detect silences. You can be in simple mode where it will just automatically detect your silences. Look at these gray spots. It automatically detected those and it will just delete them if you hit apply. Voila! And that's all you have to do, basically one click. However, remember how I paused there and said that I didn't want to delete that space for whatever reason? Maybe there's a shorter space that you don't want to delete. Okay, so now let's go into expert mode. We were in simple mode. Now we need to click on expert mode. And we have this menu bar, and you can choose the sensitivity. So you can choose the sensitivity of sound. So in other words, if it's really, really quiet, you want to determine how quiet it must be for it to delete. So you can make it more or less sensitive. So let's put it about there. And then you can choose your minimum silence duration. So here we have, it's got this little tiny segment where we wanted to leave it. So in order to not delete that segment, we're going to have to increase this to 1.5 seconds. And then you can hit apply. And voila, you have an automatically trimmed piece of audio. There are other effects you can insert, like fade in or fade out, like if it's music and you want it to gradually get louder or quieter, maybe at the beginning or the end. There are other effects you can loop, crossfade, amplify, learn your noise profile, edit. I mean, they're just a whole bunch of more advanced features that are quite easy to use and understand. They don't require a degree in audio to do this. So now let's just save our file. And we're done. We can listen to it if we want. Okay, now we are recording, and I'm also going to pause here to show you how to delete in the middle. Okay, sounds pretty good. Over and out.